comes the last item in the safe. Lot number 208. Innocent, artist unknown. This world-famous picture was the last acknowledged masterpiece of the Earth's telling period. I'll start the bidding at 700 million. I have 700 million. 800 million. Yes, I have 8. 900 million? Thank you. Against you, sir. All done, then. All done at 900 million. Sold at 900 million. The painting will be retained here for 7 days to complete the usual formalities and then released to its new owner. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Take on this job.
I know that we had plenty of other good offers, so why turn them all down for this crummy old break-in?
The heroin running along the coast would have been fun. Taking out the government's gold reserve sounded good, too.
We should have tried to get in touch with Mr. Bing.
Now that creepy go-between is dead.
He would have hired us for something.
There's a time in every android's career when he'll do a job for reasons apart from money. One is to accomplish the greatest aspect of his program. A second is because he owes a debt.
Is this gonna be what you call a masterpiece?
No, I don't know what that's gonna be yet.
Then you're paying a debt back. It's something you owe someone.
I don't owe nothing to nobody.
Then it must be for the money. Oh, what a bore.
Oh, hey! Why'd you hit me? What have I said?
There's another reason neither of you two would understand, so I won't waste my breath. Quit your complaining and keep paddling. I need time to think.
Think he might have a few screws loose?
I'm a bit concerned about the boy's mechanics.
We're here! Yeah!
Mm-hmm.
I can feel we're right under the auction house storeroom. If we hit trouble and find that we get separated in the store, meet at the usual place in 24 hours. You got that?
Yeah, we heard, but all this trouble to get his hands on a boring bit of art?
What's in it for you and me? We're wasting our time.
Maybe we'll find something. There could be gold or diamonds.
That sounds better.
Forgive thy humble servant, my brethren, for keeping you all in limbo. But now it's showtime! Your host this evening, the lovely Leona Ozeki.
Hi there, everybody. It's Fun Quiz.
Yeah, terrific.
I want want you to meet Mario the Drug Pusher, the first of our players. The thing is, though, he won't speak to me, not a word all day.
In that case, he doesn't need his tongue, so I might as well cut it out of him.
Right, I say cut it out scientifically.
Wait a second, you guys. I got rights too, you know. I read the Constitution. It says that I got a right to stay silent, and that's the rules.
Reading too much could blind him. It can make you blind. Ain't that a fact, Spitz?
Yeah, I was reading something like that in the Police Gazette.
So the first question, who supplied the heroin you were pushing on the street today? No hurry, you've got 20 seconds.
You ain't scaring me with your bluff, it ain't gonna work.
Hey, what an answer!
Dearest Father, receive his soul. Let me give unto him the instrument of thy infinite power and mercy.
Ah!
I'll bet on him to hold out for 40 seconds.
Don't flatter him, Al. He just doesn't look the 40-second type. I say 20 top.
Hey, shut up, you guys, and get your bets on the table. I'm betting on 15, and that's pretty high for him.
God bets 25 seconds.
Thanks. Rien va plus. I reckon 30 seconds, but I'm a real bad loser, so make sure you keep quiet that long. Hey, ready? Start her up.
That's pretty good. I think you've underestimated him.
Me?
I've won! 31 so far. I've won!
Oh!
Oh!
I can finally go off Judy! All the paperwork's been finished and cleaned up. Girls, here I come! Files. Messed up again. I'll kill him. I'll boil him in tank sump oil. Britain! Look what you did.
It wasn't me. It sounded as if a grenade exploded. Remember, I was here helping you get all these damage claims sorted out. Huh?
Well, who's fool enough to play with a grenade?
I'll bet it was Leon Ozaki.
The guards will be unconscious for the rest of the night. Hey, what the? What's going on, huh?
Peters brought us on vacation for a month on the Côte d'Azur. Mornings lying on the beach, then tennis, then glorious nights of violent passion. It's all such an unutterable bore. Where will I find fulfillment? Father lusts after my sister, mother goes mad in the Nordic winter, and me? What do I have to live for, except the joy of suicide?
Cut it out! We ain't here to get dressed in antique fancy clothes and sit around on our asses. We're here to get innocent, right? So we ain't got any time to waste on amateur theatricals. And anyway, your lines are really terrible.
You ain't got no soul! Can't a girl let all that inner despair out once in a while?
My God, how like a man. Sensitivity isn't their thing.
That isn't fair. I can't help how crude guys are, so cut the shit and get looking for innocent, okay?
Oh, we found the crummy picture.
Huh?
He was hung with a lot of other stuff in the next room. Not particularly well hung, I gotta say.
Ah. Yeah. It's me. There's no doubt about it. It's me, right down to the mole on my belly. Now do you understand why I had to have it?
It's just a man holding his hands up. And fat. But look, Hannah Puma, don't you think this is more my style?
Well, I think it's weird they could sell that for 900 million.
What do you think they'd pay for a nude of us?
I don't know. Not that much. That's why I'm so humiliated and mad.
What?
Well, look at us. We're beautiful and sexy, but no one would pay that kind of money for us. What's he got that we haven't?
Red Commando, watch it. They can play rough, so keep both eyes on him. They don't like guys like us trying to steal the loot that they're guarding.
You can't take innocent. We've been employed to guard it. Listen carefully. I'm only going to say this once. Put it back.
No, I can't. I need it. It's my existence.
We don't give a shit about the other things. They're not in our contract. But put the picture back where you found it.
It's time for some action, wouldn't you say?
I would indeed. I'd say it's more than time. Hey, I got a surprise, kid. Hi, Commando!
He'll be okay. He's like me and you. It doesn't harm us to breathe a bit of the bacterial gas. We just shouldn't breathe in too much. A bit of it won't hurt Bonaparte.
But Al, you don't understand. The grenade exploded right next to him. He could have been blown to bits, destroyed completely. Oh, you poor baby. You're fine now. Mommy's here. Oh! He's got a scratch. He's got a scratch. Don't sit there like a dummy. Do something. Bonaparte's got a scratch.
Don't enjoy getting caught on. I don't enjoy getting hit either.
Thanks. That's just what I need right now. Ready? You've won today's jackpot. Ah!
No! Stop it! Please, please stop, Otaka!
Too late! No mercy! You really asked for it, bastard!
Be merciful, my child. Which would our Lord say is more valuable, the life of a miserable sinner or a tank?
Well, a tank, of course.
Right. Thanks be to God for letting thy lamb hear the true word that giveth the tank police the power which it needs to carry on the struggle.
Hey, wait a minute. If I give Bonaparte a lick of paint, that should fix him like new.
You'll paint him? Well, that's about the nicest offer that I ever had.
It'd be a pleasure.
It's really appreciated.
Consider it done.
I hope you don't mind if I say what a swell guy you are.
Then you wouldn't be too insulted if I asked you to come out for dinner tonight?
No, of course not. But I have to know if the restaurant has underground parking.
Why, yeah, they got underground parking.
Then I'd love to come.
What makes you ask that?
I wouldn't risk Bonaparte having to stay out where the bacterial cloud might hurt him.
Great to be a young pair of lovers, eh, Specs? I went out for a meal with a 5-inch cockroach last week, but I wouldn't pretend it was that much fun.
And when I eat in the lab surrounded by urine samples, it makes me throw up.
We mustn't forget our good friend Mario, who's still waiting for his shot at the big prize.
We got an emergency, men. Make with the speed.
Act not with unseemly haste, for there is some emergency in our fair city every 36 seconds, so saith the mayor.
It's a special kind of emergency, though.
Ain't it always a special kind of emergency, though, boss?
Get it into your heads. It's serious.
Let's postulate a bipolar scale. Would you say it scores 1, 4, 7, or right up to the bell?
Listen, clown, it's the kind of emergency you'd get the second Bwaku and his gang ride into town. Now, how serious is that?
That's a pretty serious one.
They're holed up in a shootout in a branch of a joint called Westerby's, and the chief said it's choked with all kinds of treasure and gold.
Lieutenant, did you say Westerby's, the great auctioneer's place?
And they have lots of statues with enormous tits and bums.
Yeah, well, it's great to see I've got some interest out of you at last. Now tell us, how are you going to rate this emergency on the scale that you worked out? 10?
Yeah, I always loved it.
Lieutenant, I can't wait to get there.
Right, let's get down there and take control of events. Okay, let's go.
Yo!
Can't you see the direction you're firing in? Ow! Why is this thing attacking me? It ain't me you're trying to hit. It's that red killer in the corner. Can't you see that he's hiding there?
And that's the direction I'm firing in. Quit leaping about or you might get hurt.
Can't you take it in that he's there in that direction?
Give the guy another burst.
Okay. Suppose you fire at me instead. Your aim's so lousy, I'll be safer like that.
I'm really offended that you believe that.
Cease fire! It made no difference!
You're still firing in the same direction. Do you realize that?
Yeah, just teaching him a lesson.
You gun-crazy cat gangster!
Listen, the Red Commander's got you once already with his knife. Buaku, you keep your head down and we'll take care of him. Better still, you better get out of here. You're too weak for a fight and you'll be in the way. But you can use your fireball if you have to fight.
I don't know if I brought it. Yeah, it's right here. I got it.
You should have enough strength to use it, but if we keep the only spray can containing antidote, that gives you a real strong hand against an attacker.
Annapurna, you're right. I gotta get out of here. That stab wound really hurts. Oh, what am I doing going without this? Strange. Yeah!
Yep, looked like Buaku and his cat gang bit off more than they could friggin' chew, huh?
Yeah, but as it ain't us tank police, do you think it'd be a SWAT team that's got him cornered?
No way, it's those sissies. They couldn't hold Buaku up in there for 10 seconds.
I suppose it has to be security men, then. They're doing pretty well.
Leona, saddle up that little peewee tank of yours and see what the shooting's all about. Looks like someone's trying to muscle in on our work, and we don't like opposition. If you ain't back out again in 5 minutes, I'll order the rest of the guys to come in after you. On second thoughts, make that 7, and then I can finish my dinner.
On our way! Okay, we'll take the side alley.
Here we go.
The combination of art and money has produced work of immense value, but the slightest alteration renders the priceless work of art worthless. This means that vast sums of money are spent on what must inevitably become garbage.
Careful! Watch your step, Al!
I'm trying to. It isn't easy to avoid every treasure in here because there's no room to maneuver accurately.
I don't care about the pictures, but if you were to scratch Bonaparte's paintwork, I'd make you respray him and polish him up till he looked like new.
Shit!
Well, what wonderful timing. And does that painting there happen to have been stolen?
Hey, have they started sending girls to do man-sized work now?
One move and I'll shoot! Anyway, I don't think you'd get too far nursing that stab wound you've got. Shit. Jeez, Bonaparte.
What's up, Leona?
He stuck something on my neck and I can't get it off. What is it, Al?
So you won't forget this unplanned meeting, allow me to present you with a bio ball, which will never come off again.
What the hell's a bio ball?
They're pretty nasty. Keep quite still.
Let's get him! Charge!
Lieutenant, where have you taken Leona? She's gonna need all the help we can give.
Sorry, Al, but there's some real bad news to tell. Buaku slipped through our trap and taken Leona with him.
Huh?
Struggle, the tighter the bio ball wraps its tentacles around you. Once it's on, that's it. It don't come off again. A buddy of mine was tripping once and decided it'd be a gas to try it on himself. For 3 days and three nights, that thing put him through sheer hell. He was begging me to finish him off. In the end, I felt so sorry for the poor bastard, I agreed to try and rip the thing off. Well, I'm a pretty strong guy, and I did it. The trouble was that half his brain stem came away with it.
We don't scare that easy in the tank, please, and unless you get this thing off, now!
Let's make a deal. We have the special spray that'll remove it. It ain't the same kind issued to the police or that the doctors use. They wouldn't be any good to you.
Got it all worked out, pal. But if it's curtains for me, you're gonna come along as well. How does that deal sound?
Unless you help me, I'm not gonna make it anymore. The Red Commando's knife went in too deep. But if you do help me, I'll antidote the bio ball and get it off. I'll go free, and so we'll both have a nice, happy ending.
I'm not about to make a deal with a murderous creep, and that's final.
You're making a mistake, a brave decision, but wrong. And all I want is this picture of me as innocent. Nothing more.
I know what that painting's worth. It sold for 900 million.
It's not the money that interests me for once, I swear.
Then why do you want it?
Agree to do a deal, and then I'll tell you. Oh, shit, I think I...
Don't die! You gotta get me the antidote!
You lump of desiccated panda shit!
Don't bail me out anymore, Chief!
You call yourself a tank policeman, letting her get killed and still alive to tell the tale? Get out of here!
Be fair, Chief. Al did a pretty fine job. Besides, I recall a conversation we had where you said that sometimes you felt like murdering her. I know Buaku's dumb, but I don't think even he'd be prepared to kill a police officer in cold blood. He isn't that dumb.
He who expresses deep anger can also express deep love. It's just that I'm desperately worried about that poor kid.
One more thing. What happened to the rest of the gangsters that were there?
You better rest up, Al. You don't need to bother about that.
Well, the fact is they all kind of got away.
Hey! I don't like guys that take a friggin' holier-than-thou attitude. Got it? Didn't I even see you letting one gun girl escape?
Yeah, I admit it.
Shut up, then.
I wish I could have done something to try and save her.
Take not this burden on thyself.
If it was the lieutenant they'd taken as a hostage, I guess I could live with that.
Gee, thanks.
But not Leona.
Listen, kid, I've been real patient, but now you better go.
Back off. I tell you, if they had taken you instead, I wouldn't lose much sleep.
What?
You really mean it, Chief? Right then, I quit.
Oh, yeah.
I'm dead, but I'm gonna take you bastards with me.
Before you do, Lieutenant, I got a question for you.
That's quite an outfit you've got.
The painting my men were employed to watch over at Westerby's store. Where have you taken that picture?
Ah, yeah. So, can I take it you're talking about Red Commandos when you're speaking about your men?
The painting's disappeared from where it should be.
You were the guards in the shootout which us guys put a stop to.
Where is that painting gone?
Huh?
For the last time, what have you done with Innocent?
Look, Sunshine, we ain't got either the time or inclination to waste energy yakking to you about a painting or anything else, especially now they're holding an officer of ours. Get out of here while you can still do it in one piece.
Since you asked so politely...
You mean that I really scared you into going?
You've told me enough that the painting is safe. They wouldn't take a hostage purely in order to escape, and certainly not a cop. May I warn you, we'll play rough to recover the painting. I would therefore advise you, Lieutenant, to keep well clear of me.
That fella strikes me as antisocial.
You ain't kidding, Chief, because them Red Commandos ain't got the same morals that we train our men to always live up to. They're a private army, and they'll do whatever's required to get the painting back, and that includes kidnapping or murder or thieving.
Well, that'll put Leona in worse danger.
This has all the ingredients of tragedy.
You lied! You've got no antidote to stop the bioball action! You lied to me! Cut it out! You're overacting!
What have I done to you? What have I done? Don't go on with it! No! Don't go on!
As doctors of abnormal psychology, our role is to study, not to judge. It is not our role to argue the moral rights and wrongs of the project. Your job is to record every detail of our experiments here with meticulous care.
But, sir...
Is that clear? The world is contaminated by the bacterial cloud, so this project has assumed national, no, international, not to say global importance. We have already succeeded in creating a prototype life form capable of surviving in bacterially contaminated air. On the physical side, then, the project is incontestably a total success. The challenge we now face is to create a mental framework, completely human in form. At the moment, the brains in our specimens exist, but they exist up till now only in a state I would term cognitive sterility.
A mental state of cognitive barrenness implies complete innocence.
Perhaps. But we can be sure that it is without memory, without experience, without education, a blank page. What could such a being accomplish? To what could he aspire? The brain requires food from the body to keep its systems functioning. But imagine a body that does not require food. What would the brain need to sustain the mind? That is the question facing psychologists.
And it is that our research is attempting to answer?
Our program is collecting the data on which the answer will eventually be based. Of course, there is no human being. Indeed, it would be a contradiction in terms, with a body needing no nourishment and a brain in a state of cognitive sterility. We dare not experiment on our prototype. We use these semi-clones.
They are so human in appearance.
Perhaps, but their cognitive functions remain entirely unused. What we call their brains are made of microchips, replicas of adult human brains. We shall have the privilege of imprinting experience on them. Till now, only God has known what it is to create human intellect from nothing. That is our task here, to create human intellect from nothing. The Circulatory and Respiration Lifeform Project provided a convenient cover for what is the true quest of those of us in the field of abnormal psychology. We ourselves will become as gods if we achieve our ultimate goal, that goal being nothing less than the definition and classification of the human soul. I cannot deny a certain sympathy for our subjects, however. They have no idea of their own situation. No say in their own fate.
Did I talk while I was out? Where is it?
Tank police officers carry first aid kits. It won't do the trick long, but I reckon it's better than nothing.
What did I say when I was asleep?
All kinds of stuff that I couldn't make a lot of sense of. And you aren't carrying the spray can of bioball antidote!
Yes, that's correct. My two cat friends have it, and you'll get some when you get me to them.
Promise?
Absolutely. And does this mean that we've got a deal?
A deal with a crook. Would the guys understand?
I ain't human, you know.
That was clear to me while I was bandaging your wound.
I wasn't built to lie as human beings lie when it suits them. I told you where I've got the antidote, which means I have it.
What are you doing?
It's too bulky with its frame. I'll carry it rolled up.
I still haven't agreed that we've got a deal, though.
Time's getting very short.
My men are making progress. I'm not in a position to offer you an absolute guarantee at this stage. One thing more. The tank police may become a nuisance to me. Please have them eliminated. That might well be crucial to us.
Noise, a whirlpool.
Ah, the water will drag us under.
We can't get clear of the current. It'll cut us to pieces.
Not if I can help it. We fight in the tank, Felisa. Ah! Grab the rope.
Got it. Hang on tight.
少し普通に